doing this. Good morning, friends. Today is the day. We are attempting to eat 10,000 calories today. Yes, it is early. To be exact, it's actually 7:05 a.m. right now. Anyone that may be new to this challenge, rules are pretty simple. You can't drink any calories, so you have one day to complete the challenge, effectively from the time you wake up till the time you go to bed. And if you throw up, you are out. Those are the rules, as far as I can tell. All right, let's go. I'm doing something a little bit different. I'm actually going to have something to eat and then go for a swim because trying to obviously increase my hunger throughout the day, plus burn off a few calories.
The destination is on your right.
I don't normally swim, but I do know that swimming for me does definitely get my appetite going. And I'm gonna be honest, right now, I'm not really hungry. I'm not up this time normally. Hopefully that's why. I'm gonna start early. Disclaimer, I'm not the fastest eater out there. I've got to film it because that's what you have to do for these challenges. Obviously, I'm going to speed it up. I don't know, personally, I think it's a little bit weird to someone watching you eat. I thought I'd do something a little bit different. So while I eat, obviously, I'll record that, speed that up. And then I was actually at the Arnold Expo a few weeks ago in Melbourne. And I recorded a bunch of like the athletes, like YouTube athletes who have done this challenge and recorded their responses asking for tips and advice for me to actually do the challenge. So I'll overlay that on top of me eating and doing the challenge. Hopefully that makes it a little bit more interesting for people who may actually not want to just watch me eat. Yeah. About to the first meal. You may guess where we are. We are at McDonald's, yes. I have not had McDonald's in years, I reckon. I can't even remember the last time I had it. Anyway, without further ado, let's go. All right, meal one, we've got a sausage and egg muffin, hash brown, and of course, some water. Because health.
I'm here with the man himself, Steve Cook. As you know, I'm doing the 10,000 calorie challenge. What advice does Steve Cook recommend?
My advice for you would be the day before.
Almost forgot. Starting time 7:53.
Have a very, very intense HIIT session. It'll make you hungrier. Okay. It'll also help with that post-oxidative consumption. So have a weight session the day before and a very, very intense HIIT session. Okay. And then when you wake up in the morning, I would say get a good meal in you. And that might sound a little bit weird, but okay. I noticed that if I get a good meal in me, it makes me hungrier later on in the day.
End time, 7:56.
Right. So what time are you going to do this challenge at?
I'm going to wake up about 7 a.m.
7 a.m.?
7 a.m.
Wait, is it 10,000 calories throughout the day?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you're good then. You reckon? I can do that, yeah. You can do that.
You did that for lunch?
Yeah, that's my normal lunch. But no, even swimming the previous day.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Swimming gets you starving. Yeah, right. You do that even the morning before you start.
Yeah.
I don't know right. If you want to do it after you eat. Just space it out and don't quit until, you know, last meal, best meal. That's what we said.
Do Steve Cook say. Is that gonna be a t-shirt next
time? Yeah, we can do that. Last meal, best meal.
Yeah, sick. Thanks, bro.
Let me know how that goes.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, I don't feel amazing after that, but like, obviously I'm not full of that. Right, that's the first meal done. Off now to go do a swim, leaving a bit of time between eating and swimming.
It's not often I'm up early, and gee, you can really see those goggle marks, don't you? But doing a bit of morning cardio. Swim done. Next meal.
Time for meal number two. And I am definitely feeling hungry after that swim. Shout out to Steve Cook, thanks for that idea. Although he did say he would recommend not eating then swimming. Look, it's about 9:30 now, and I had to get something in, otherwise if I went for a swim and then ate nothing, I would be starting the challenge, I think, on the back foot. But yeah, I am definitely hungry now. And, you know, taking the stairs because health. Meal number two, we are at a place in Australia, I'm not sure if overseas has it, it's called Pancake Parlour. We have Chocolate Jubilee, which is a chocolate pancake with cream, vanilla ice cream, Belgian chocolate chips, and their house-made hot chocolate fudge served with fresh strawberries because, you know, health. Here we go. Oh, and of course water, because health again. Starting time, 10:07. That is really good.
What up, guys? He was pushing his mind.
I am wishing luck on the 10-day challenge. I can't do it. Rob did it. Are you dieting right now, or are you?
Yeah, I'm actually doing a competition.
Okay. I was mid-bulk when I started, but I think if you're kind of like lean, I think it'd be a lot easier. Yeah, if you're lean and kind of hungry, that'd be easy.
Is this a new target?
Maybe do like 3-4 days of like a deficit, cardio, so you're really hungry. I was just like, I was even hungry at home. I was baseball.
If you're bulking up, you like better.
I had no appetite. I was hungry to eat, so cool. Are you getting it?
Thank you. Finishing time 10:13. That went down really good, but the strawberries definitely made that.
Some time has got on now. It is about 12 o'clock. That is probably too long between meals, but had to do a few errands, pick up some supplies for the meals later on. While I was out, picked up trusty Donut King. Got 2 cinnamon donuts and a hot jam donut. Think I will do the cinnamon donuts now. Probably chill for a little bit, not too long, because, you know, the day's getting on. I'm not too worried. I've left a lot of leg room for time. I got up pretty early, so should be good. But yeah, I'll eat the cinnamon donuts now, and then eat the hot jam donut, and then probably head to the gym, do a full body workout. Here we go. Don't you just love hot cinnamon donuts? If only you could smell these.
Any advice? I would have to give them... Okay, you're gonna have to start eating early.
My bad. Starting time. 12:05.
I made a big mistake. I started eating like around 10 o'clock, so that was like the biggest mistake I could possibly make. I would say wake up maybe like 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock and start eating immediately. Yeah, because it, trust me, 10,000 calories, it's a lot. Yeah, go like
10%, right? Yeah. 2 cinnamon donuts done. I keep forgetting to do this. 12:08. Time to get changed, have that jam ball donut, and head to the gym. Time for that hot jam donut. Well, not so hot anymore, so we're going to heat that up in the microwave and enjoy. Ooh, yes. Time is 12:53. Face to face, out in the heat. Well, 55. Good pre-workout meal. Not the standard. Sometimes I do actually have pre-workout before, but obviously pre-workout is basically caffeine. And caffeine has been told to be a hunger suppressant, which is not what we want. We want our hunger to ramp up, not be shutting down. So I think all that sugar can be plenty enough to get us through. Let's go. Okay, so I know I did say I was going to do a full body workout, but to be honest, I'm not feeling as bad as I was expecting, and I know I haven't done that many. I've done about 2,000, and I know a lot of you are probably thinking, gee, it's pretty late in the day, he's not going to do this. From what I've seen, a lot of people start off really strong, like early on, and then they feel so average throughout the rest of the day. So my thinking was a little bit different, which obviously you've seen so far, but I'm feeling better than I was expecting to be feeling by this point. I think I'm just going to do a chest workout, try and fit in with my normal routine. I'll just superset to try and burn some more calories and keep the energy high. I'll run through the workout real quick, if anything, because like this video is obviously a lot different to my normal videos. Normally, like, this channel is about fitness and traveling, which you can obviously check out other videos. And a lot of you are probably new to the channel that haven't seen a video before. But make sure to subscribe, we've got some good videos coming soon. I won't let you down. Workout done, feeling pretty good. Not feeling sick at all. Obviously, I know I haven't had that many yet, but don't worry, we're about to ramp up. I am feeling pretty hungry. So you know what establishment our next meal is gonna be at. Of course, McDonald's, we've got large fries and quarter pounder. I'm putting it on a plate because we're classy. So the time now is 3:08. Here we go.
What's up, guys? This boy is about to do the 10,000 calorie challenge. Want some advice? The biggest piece of advice I would say is don't underestimate it, because you're gonna.
And of course, we got water because
You guessed it. Health.
You're gonna get to 5,000 pretty easy, right? You're like, that's easy. Yeah. You're gonna get to 7,000, maybe even 8,000. You're like, I got it, dude. Okay. The last 2,000 to 3,000 calories are the hardest things you'll ever do in your life.
Okay.
The food that you once loved, you will hate. Your jaw will hurt from chewing.
Yeah, right.
And you'll start eating whatever you can to fill in those calories. You'll start eating stuff you wouldn't even normally eat, just to, like, knock out calories. And start early. That's a big thing.
Yeah. Okay.
Start as early as you can, because as soon as you're done eating one thing, you have to already start thinking of, like, when can I start eating the next meal? Because you're gonna run out of time.
Right.
Because at first you're like, oh, you know, 10 hours. 1,000 calorie meal, but like it doesn't work out like that all the time.
Yeah, right. What time are you starting your one on Saturday?
Probably like 7 in the
morning. Okay, that's what I'm thinking too. That's a good time to start.
Best of luck, buddy.
Thanks for everything.
Finishing time 3:16. You're not feeling too bad after that. I'm a bit surprised because I haven't had McDonald's in years, I reckon.
Time to have a quick shower and then we'll get stuck into the next meal. Done. Let's eat. Next meal. I think I'm gonna enjoy this. We have cookies and cream cheesecake and we have Nutella. So we're gonna get 200 grams of this Nutella, melt this, put it on top of that cheesecake. So we have 200 grams of Nutella. So we're gonna heat that up. And then we're gonna pour this on top of this cheesecake. So that was half a tub of Nutella. This looks amazing. So that's all that's left. Time for the next meal. As you saw me prepare, we have a cookies and cream cheesecake with half a tub of Nutella melted on top of this. For anyone wondering, this meal alone is 2,500 calories, which it's more than my daily intake currently. So we're gonna get stuck into this. I don't know how long this will take me, but cookies and cream cheesecake is one of my favorites, which is why I got this. Do love Nutella as well, so you know. I think a key with this challenge is to eat foods that you obviously enjoy and want to eat. I mean, probably Captain Obvious there, but that's the way it is. Anyway, starting time 4:25.
I am here with Honey Summers, aka Mum Bunny.
What's going on, guys?
Wow, this tastes amazing.
What advice do you have for me to try and get through?
Okay, that's something that I want to do as well. I'm going to be doing it very soon. But I would suggest, like, starting fresh. So have, like, a healthy-ish breakfast.
Okay.
Go train legs.
Yeah.
And then start eating, like, you know, naughtier foods. And then just, like, go crazy. Do, like, 10,000 calories. Try to get as many as you can. And maybe do, like, a smaller muscle workout, like shoulders. That way, like, your body is exhausted, you know, from two workouts in a day. That's my plan. Anyway.
Okay.
That way, like, your body kind of wants a 10,000 calories.
Okay.
You know, it might not want it, but you can force it in there.
Okay.
But yeah, I always suggest doing legs like early in the morning. That way, like, your body is kind of like needs to give me food and whatnot. But don't start off with like 7 donuts or like.
Everyone's saying that, actually.
Do not do that.
You don't think I should do that?
No. If you start off like that, then you're just going to set yourself up for failure.
Okay,
that's interesting. Some people can do that, but I feel like if you start like healthy-ish, like cleaner foods in the morning, get in a workout.
This challenge just got real. Up until now, I was feeling pretty good. But it just got real. I don't know, I'm probably like 2/3 of the way through this. I might pause for a little bit. I'm gonna come back. All right, we gotta finish this. 4:51.
Feel really good. And like, all right, let's like tackle the rest of the day.
Okay. Well, thank you. I appreciate that. Hope
good
to
luck.
Get through
good
it.
Luck.
Good luck to
I'm
you.
Excited for you.
Thank you. Here's Rob Lipsit. You guys know him, he's probably done 10,000 and 20,000 calories.
I don't know if I'm like proud or ashamed of that.
Far out, man.
Right, so Matt, piece of advice is, of course, choose foods that you like and that you enjoy. So try to make the challenge as enjoyable as possible.
Right.
And probably the biggest tip debate between sweet and savory.
That's good advice.
It's like the way, you know, there's always room for dessert.
Yeah,
so
right.
like taste buds change and stuff, so it just makes it way easier.
So that 5,000 calorie chocolate bar,
yes.
Do you recommend or no?
This is getting very real. I'm gonna get through it. Man, oh man.
No, that was the worst choice ever. Like, it was funny, but you know, that's about it. It was just so hard to eat. It was so big.
That was great. You got through it. You melted it down.
Yeah.
Taking I'm sure you guys see the video.
Yeah,
so. Smart man. Appreciate it, Rob.
Best of luck.
Thanks, Rob.
I'm gonna come back. Again. Obviously, some time has passed. I don't know why this one I'm really struggling with. Up until now, I've been fine. I think it's the Nutella. We got to keep moving because we still have 4,500 calories to do after this. I don't know if it's a mental game right now, and if it is, I'm gonna win the mental game. That's done. Thanks to Rob Lipsit, which you've heard, his tip was to go from sweet, savory, savory, sweet, whatever, alternate. So the next thing, obviously that was very sweet. We are going to go savory. But finishing time, this is pretty disgraceful. Finishing time of 6:07. I'm gonna definitely need a bit of time to chill. So we'll check in the next meal. Not gonna lie. I'm not feeling great after that. I've gone for a walk around the block, which actually, to be honest, has made me feel a bit better, but I've been lying here for not sure how long. And I know I need to keep moving because, yes, it's obviously dark now, the day's ticking. It's time to get on with the next meal. When you need a lot of calories and a savory dish, where else would you go? That's right, Pizza Hut coming in clutch. So I'm going to get a pepperoni lovers, which that is obviously in kilojoules of how much that is. But if I've converted that to cross, that is about 1760 calories. All right, it's time for the next meal. Pizza Hut coming in with the heavy calories. Here we go. Starting time 8:18.
I'm now joined by Sean and Stafford.
What's up, guys? How's it going? Australian accent, you like it?
Actually pretty good.
What's up, guys? How's it going? Hello. How are you?
Can you say g'day, mate?
Good day, mate.
That's pretty good.
G'day, mate.
Have you done the 10,000 calorie challenge?
I have.
Yeah.
I have. Yeah.
I haven't seen it.
It was easy. I didn't vlog it. It's a bit of fun.
Yeah, right.
Not everything's about a vlog. Sometimes
that's
it's
true.
About just living for the moment. Living for the moment. Getting them calories
that's
in.
That's very true. What's your advice to do 10,000 calories in one day?
My advice for the 10,000 calorie challenge is don't be a fool and go for something like oatmeal for breakfast.
Yeah, good call.
Schoolboy error. Go for something super high calorie that's not that filling. Early doors.
Is that donuts?
Donuts, pastries, that sort of stuff. Because
yeah.
I think the rules for the challenge is obviously that you can't drink it, right? You can't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of people have broken that.
Yeah, there's a lot of cheaters out there. We know who you are.
Halfway. Rob is right that going from sweet, savory, savory, sweet helps. But gee, it's still a lot, isn't it? We're gonna get that.
Go early and go as high calorie as you can. You know what? If you can knock over 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 calories, you can go 9 in the morning.
Yeah, yeah.
The rest of the day is cruising.
Yeah, exactly.
Really cruising. Okay. So you're doing 10,000 calories to celebrate hitting 10,000 followers.
That's correct. Yes, you're right. Nick Priest.
Everyone that's not following Nick Priest, follow at Nick Priest. Do it.
Sean said it.
And next year we'll be doing a 12,000 calorie challenge.
Thanks, Sean.
Richard. Thank you for having me. Is this for your YouTube? Anyone that's watching this video, make sure you come and hit this button right here. Come subscribe. It's a great channel.
Thanks, bro.
I'm a tiger. I'm a tiger. Okay, party people in the house.
Finish time, 8:36. I think I'm gonna have to bring out a secret weapon to get through this, but don't worry. We're gonna make it. It's time to finish this. We have our secret weapon from Pizza Hut, the ultimate Hershey's cookie. Was warm when we got it, so we've warmed that up. That's 1503 calories. And then we have Ben & Jerry's also coming in clutch. Peanut butter with cookie core, which has 319 calories per serve. 4 servings in a packet, gives us 1276 calories. So we're gonna empty this on top of this. And last meal.
Last meal, best meal.
Done, finish this. Here we go. So we are gonna finish this thing before midnight. 11:15. Should be able to do this in 45 minutes. Wow. When I was in Houston, I had a pizookie at their BJ's restaurant. This effectively is like a homemade pizookie, obviously. If you've never had a pizookie, this is how you can make one. They were not kidding about the peanut butter core. Look at that. That is like, that is like raw peanut butter. We're close. Give me a few minutes. We're gonna finish this. Don't panic. We got half an hour. Yep. Okay. I do not want to come this close and call it, knowing that's all that's between me and finishing this. Cue motivational music. Finishing time, 11:44. I'm so glad that is done. So here's our totals for today. Just to review, we had the sausage and egg McMuffin, hash brown, chocolate jubilee, pancake parlor. Then for lunch, we had the quarter pounder, large fries, the cookies and cream cheesecake with half a tub of Nutella. Snacks, we had those two cinnamon donuts and the jam donut. Dinner, we had the pepperoni pizza, the Hershey's cookie from Pizza Hut, and the Ben & Jerry's ice cream. This gives a total of 10,032. The actual total is 10,015. Reason being, these are as close as I could find on MyFitnessPal. This, though, for Ben & Jerry's is actually 1276 according to the packet. According to the Pizza Hut website, that is 1760. And according to the website, that Hershey's cookie is 1503. So slight variations, but they're as close as I could get. But still, it's over 10,000. It's 10,015, not 10,032. To look at the macros today, gee, we well and truly went over, didn't we? Wow, that's not good. Well, that is it. I am in no rush to be doing anything like that again. I am definitely going to go into a food coma. I don't know how long for, because yeah, I do not feel great after that, for sure. But we did it. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Hope it provided some entertainment for you. Thank you for 10,000 followers on Instagram, which is the whole reason I did this challenge. So, if you don't already, as Sean said, follow me on Instagram here. And if you do, thank you so much. This video is because of you. We will see you next time, which will not be a food challenge video. Alright.